Dr. Karen Pryor passed away this week, but it reminded me of one of my favorite articles that I read that really got me sort of into the idea of how reinforcement could be used. And that is her 1969 article with Richard Hogg and Joseph O'Reilly called The Creative Porpoise, Training for Novel Behavior.
Such a classic.
Such a classic, right. And it's actually not a hard read. It's a really easy read, even though it's in the Journal of the Experimental Analysis. So they went in, they were working with bottlenose dolphins. Their intent was to train them to emit novel behavior through reinforcement. So they systematically reinforced variability and creativity in the porpoise's behavior. And so what they saw was that these dolphins were emitting more and more creative and novel responses across the sessions. So it was one of the first studies to empirically show that reinforcement contingencies could actually shape novel behavior rather than just reinforce pre-existing or imitated behavior. So I think that, you know, from my experience and when I first read it, and I, even today for anyone picking it up and reading it, it really shows how reinforcement principles can be applied to creativity and problem solving. It's not just rote learning, which we've talked about before. We're not, you know, just trying to get robots, right? And this is true for both animals, but also for humans. So it has implications for any behavior analysts who are interested in teaching novel responses to their learners. Language development, play, problem solving. And there's been so many subsequent studies that have sort of used these principles in the same way to demonstrate innovation rather than just repetition.